This is episode 8 of Blue Hose Break, featuring head football coach Steve Englehart and head women's soccer coach Brian Purcell. This episode of Blue Hose Break is brought to you by Berkshire Hathaway.
Defense played outstanding. Obviously, you know, they were, if you look at the stats and if you hold someone to 185 yards of total offense and 22 yards passing, you probably think you're going to win the game. And unfortunately, we gave them points in other areas of the game, you know, special teams and obviously offense with two turnovers. Got to give credit for Maris for, you know, creating and causing those turnovers. You know, feel like that was, you know, probably more on us, though, things that we just gave them, you know, kind of felt like we gave that stuff to them. But got to give credit for them for capitalizing, you know, on those opportunities. You know, our first turnover, still believe that it was a forward pass. Arm was clearly coming forward, you know, obviously can't do nothing about it, but we're going to turn into the officiating crew and see what they say about it. You know, got to continue to fight in this league to get replay. There's just, you know, if it could just get one call right, you know, just get one call right, replay, I think it's worth it, you know, especially a game-changing call like that leads to points. And you know, and then we had a roughing, well, it was a running into the punter on Ezra King that was called a running into to the punter, and I don't know the definition of running into the punter or roughing, but it was clearly the guy blocking it left his feet and was in midair and collided with Ezra. So I don't know what roughing or running into the punter is, but you know, so which could have obviously given us a first down there to continue a drive. So you know, but we got to play better on offense. We can't do some of the things that we did that put us behind. You know, too many penalties. As you know, we talked about 10 penalties for 110 yards. That ended up equaling a lot more yards than that. When you know, you have a 25 yard gain. You know, Kibbe caught a pass for 25 yards, but it was negated by a penalty. You know, you have a punt return for a touchdown negated by a penalty. You know, you had several others in there where it was good offensive plays that could have led to even field position, which we never really had throughout the course of the game very well. And you kind of got stuck into that deal where you're kind of backed up, and then you can move a little bit, get it punted out of there, and maybe the penalties prevented us from getting it out of there further, and then they get you and they pin you right back down. So, which was a great job by Maris and great job by their special teams of pinning us down there. You know, back on it this week, and we got a tough opponent this week. So really, all eyes need to be forward at this point, and looking at Davidson and putting all eyes on them. You know, they're the best team in the league. You know, in my opinion, you know, their culture and what they do is, and that's no disrespect to anybody else in the league. It's just kind of what they've done. You know, here of recent, that they just have done a great job of building a culture. The coach has been there now for several years, so they really know who they are and who and what they want to be. And I think they play really good on all sides of the ball. They're very disciplined. They're tough. You could tell they've done a great job in the weight room, you know, physicality wise. So it'll be a tough challenge for us to go there Saturday night at 7 up there at Davidson and play them on their home turf. I knew pretty quickly, just by our first meeting of, you know, you can kind of see his focus and his intensity level, and knowing that he had played some as a true freshman the year before I got here, and then, you know, you kind of get through spring ball and you know that, you know, he's got a chance to be a pretty good player, and then you go through a season with him and you see his toughness, and you know, we call him like the Terminator and RoboCop and everything, because the guy, I mean, he's just indestructible. He puts his body on the line every week and really cares about this program, and is one of those guys that told me right off the bat, Coach, I ain't leaving. I'm not going to duck the situation that we're in, and I'm going to be here and help fix it and help change it. So I can't say enough about Alex Harriott. You know, just awesome teammate, awesome player, lucky to have him. We're going to treat it about the same way that we did the Wofford game. Obviously, another kind of rival game, with this being our newest set of rival games with Davidson. But, treat it really the same in regards to how we're going to travel and all those things, kind of travel up there the day of the game, because it's a night game. It's only a hour and 50 minutes away, 2 hours away. So we'll get up here and do some things in the morning, let them go back, and rest for a while, and then get them back here for meetings and pregame meal, hop on the bus and go up there and try to get there about 2.5 hours before, so we have plenty of time at the stadium to get ready to go. So very similar to the way we worked it when we went up to Wofford, and our kids, I thought, played really well that game, so we'll stick with the same kind of same formula.
I think at the end of the season, I tend to reflect probably the most on, say, the seniors' careers. I think that the last 4 years, the last 35 years is almost too big to process sometimes, but I think I probably am reflecting more on the careers and the development and the progress, that we've seen with those seniors, that'll be moving on. In terms of sort of long-term, perspective. We had an alumni event a couple of weeks ago where some players came back, and that's always a special time to get to, reunite with them, see them kind of reunite with each other, and, that's always special, but each season has its own dynamics and its own story, and so it's not like it feels exactly the same each time. Each season is actually very different. It always is, and it is. I think it is for them particularly. Personally, even though it was a long time ago, that last game, that last time that you put on the uniform, when you have put in so many blood, sweat, and tears, for 4 years, and it you've invested so much, and then all of a sudden, you realize that you're done with that, and that can be pretty emotional, and it's emotional both for them and for their teammates, who have played with them and been there, been part of that same sort of soccer family. And there is a little bit, it's probably a little over dramatic, but there's a little bit of a grief process that goes on, with that. And when the players, move on, and then, you sort of have, for the spring, you sort of have the freshmen, sophomores, and juniors left without those seniors in the mix. It is actually surprising how quickly you change gears and start thinking about, the next fall. Maybe not so much about the next fall immediately, but you start thinking about, okay, where do we go from here? And, what are the next things? What are the next stages of development, for individuals? For our freshmen, they come in and they have a game 2 weeks later, after they start preseason. And so in some ways, I feel like in the spring, we get to know our freshmen for the first time, because we have some time with them to sort of explain a little bit why we've done some of the things we've done that we just didn't have time to go into in the fall. It was more just, all right, here's how we're going to do it kind of thing. And so I think for freshmen in particular, spring is a great time. That was one of the silver linings of that COVID season, when we got to play in the spring, is that we got to work with our freshmen for 6 months before we ever played a game. And that made a huge difference in, you know, just their ability, obviously, to, you know, to fit into the team structure and to understand what was expected and all those kind of things.